Hi, welcome to part 6 and the last of this video series, Telescope Basics. My name is David Fuller, host of the Eyes on the Sky weekly stargazing series that can be found at eyesonthesky.com. In this video, I will explain the various types of finders used on small, inexpensive telescopes and what you need to know about them. There are two basic types of finderscopes for telescopes: magnifying and non-magnifying finders. I'm going to cover the basics of the lower cost versions of each of these. The basic style of the zero power finder is what's known as a red dot finder, or RDF. It consists of an adjustable base which holds a small watch-sized battery, a switch, a red LED, and a clear flat lens onto which the LED's light is projected. The idea of a red dot finder is that once the finder is properly aligned with the main telescope, you can place the red dot onto the object you wish to see in the sky, since what you see in the finder is what you can see with your eyes. Then that object should be visible in the eyepiece of the main telescope. In theory, this works well for brighter objects. The problem can be when you go to look for dimmer objects, or when you are looking for objects in light-polluted areas, as many of us are. Now, if you only plan to look at bright objects like planets or the moon or other bright objects in the sky, or are good at estimating where to point the red dot finder in between second and third magnitude stars, that may not be a problem for you. Or perhaps you do live in an area where the skies really get dark and you can see those fifth and sixth magnitude stars. In those cases, a red dot finder may be just fine. The other type of finder, a magnified finder, does not suffer from this. These are basically small, wide-field view telescopes attached to the main telescope that provide a wider field of view than what can be seen in the bigger scope. And telescopes can show you more stars than what you can see naked eye. This is the same concept as being able to see far more stars in your larger telescope. To understand how much more you can see, look at the numbers on them. The first number is the magnification, the second is the aperture of the lens in millimeters. So a 6x30 is a 30 millimeter aperture finder that magnifies the view 6 times. A lot like binoculars. The typical 5x24 finderscope that comes with lower cost instruments often are of poor quality. Singlet lens, poor eyepiece, difficult to focus, and sometimes stopped down to smaller apertures than what they are stated to be. In cases such as this, using a red dot finder may be easier and better, or upgrading to a quality 6x30 or larger magnified finder. But if you're in the market to buy a scope and are not sure which to buy, I can state these things from firsthand experience. Red dot finders may not show you all the stars, but they are easy to use. Bad 5x24 finders are worse than red dot finders. However, I do know that Orion Telescopes places a good quality 6x26 magnified finder on many of their less expensive telescopes, and it does not reverse the view, making it easier to use. Now be sure to align your finderscope with your main telescope. Do this during the day by aiming the main scope at a distant object at least 1/4 mile or 1/2 kilometer away. Center an object that is not moving, such as the top of a telephone pole, tower, or tall building. Now center a prominent section of that object in your main telescope, then place a shorter focal length eyepiece in it and center that again to magnify it further. Lock the telescope in place so it doesn't move and turn the adjustment screws on the red dot finder or finderscope until the red dot or crosshairs in the finder are lined up with the object in your main telescope. Look in that main telescope again to ensure that the telescope didn't move while you did this. And when you've completed it, it will make it much easier to find objects in the night sky because the wider field of view you can see with the red dot finder or finderscope will ease the difficulty of aiming the main telescope at the object you wish to see due to the narrower telescopic field of view. So that's a quick look at inexpensive finders for astronomy telescopes and the end of this series for understanding them. With the free star charts available and weekly night sky videos at eyesonthesky.com, you are now prepared to find and see more objects in the sky. Thanks so much for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up.